So hello friend, how are you? Good. So today we will study about integration of rational function. So you must have studied the function. So topic is integration of rational function. Rational function. So let's recall rational function. What is the rational function? Rational function is the ratio of two polynomials. Ratio of two polynomials. Polynomials. Let's suppose P of x and Q of x, then P of x upon Q of x, where Q of x is not equal to 0, then this is the rational function. Let's assume, we assume that P of x upon Q of x is a proper rational function. Proper rational function means rational function. What is the proper rational function? It means degree of numerator. What is the numerator here? P of x is less than degree of denominator. So denominator is Q of x. Then this is the rational proper rational function. So suppose, what if P of x upon Q of x is a improper rational function? So suppose that, what if P of x upon Q of x is improper rational function? Improper rational function means degree of numerator is greater than denominator. Numerator is greater than denominator. So this is the improper rational function. So what we do that? First we convert P of x upon Q of x into proper rational function. So first is convert improper rational function into proper rational function. Operational function. It means, so suppose how do you convert? So P of x divided by Q of x. So there will be, suppose f of x quotient and remainder is R of x. So you can write as R of x upon Q of x. So means this function is now proper rational function, and this is the polynomial. So when you write improper function into polynomial plus proper rational function, so when you integrate this function, you can integrate these two functions. So let's take an example of improper function. So take example, integrate x square upon x plus 1 dx. So here you can see that degree of px, that is the q of x upon q of x equal to x square upon x plus 1. So here you can see that degree of numerator is greater than degree of denominator. So this is the improper rational function. So you convert this one. How do you convert improper proper rational function? So you can do that x square minus 1 plus 1, correct, and x plus 1. So here you can write as a x, so you plus, you can write as a x minus plus 1 upon x plus 1. So this way you can write as a, this one is a cosine and this one is remainder upon 2x. So now you can integrate this function. So you can write as a x square upon x plus 1 dx equal to integration x minus 1 dx plus integration 1 upon x plus 1 dx. So what will be the result? You can write x square upon 2 minus x plus, what is the integration of this one? Ln x plus 1 plus constant c. So this is the, so you can solve when given as a improper rational function to rational function, proper rational function. So this way you can solve. We will use method of partial fraction to integrate any rational function. So let's suppose that factor of denominator is given. There are many factors of given. So case one is that distinct linear factor. So let's suppose case one, distinct linear factor. So means that when q of x is given as ax plus b, cx plus c, d into px plus f, such that is given. So how do we, then we will change this qx, q of x into a partial fraction, means q of x upon q of x can be written as a upon ax plus b plus b upon cx plus d, capital C upon ex plus f plus. So this is called the, this is called partial fraction decomposition, partial fraction decomposition, decomposition of p of x upon q of x. So we will determine a, b, c. These are the constant where a, b, c are constant which is can be determined by two methods. So first one, what is the first method? First method is put the suitable value, suitable value, any two suitable value. So put the suitable value of variable to determine the ABC. And second method is equate the coefficient of similar power of variable to find the value of ABC. When you equate, then you will get equation, and through the equation you can find ABC. So let's take example, then we can understand how do we use this method. So let's take example is that 1 upon x minus 2 x minus 3 and dx integration. So we have integrate this one. You can see that this is the distance factor is given, so you can write as a 1 upon x minus 2 into x minus 3 equal to a upon x minus 2 plus b upon x minus 3. Then solve it, 1 upon x minus 2 x minus 3 a x minus 3 plus b x minus 2 upon x minus 2 into x minus 3. So you take denominator, take numerator, so 1 equal to a x minus 3 plus b x minus 2. So use the first one, put the suitable value. So you can see that this function is defined for all the value of x. So means you can put any value which you can determine the value of a and b. So let's suppose x 3, take 3. When you take 3, then what will be the 1 equal to a 0 plus b into 1. So you can see that b equal to 1. And when you take another suitable value x, here you can take x equal to 2, then a, what will be 2, take 2 minus 1, it will be minus 1 plus b, here 0. So what will be the a equal to, taking x equal to 2, so a equal to 1 means a equal to minus 1. So you can see that a equal to minus 1, b equal to 1. So you can write this function, as a, you can write integration 1 upon x minus 2 x minus 3 equal to, here is a is minus 1 upon x minus 2 plus b is 1 upon x minus 3. So we integrate this function. When you integrate, first you will find log x minus 2 minus 1 this one plus log x minus 3 plus cos 3. So this way you can solve the rational function. Many complicated rational function. So there are many cases, like you will see the repeated non-repeated cases. So we are studying about the distance rational function. But there are many like repeated linear factor. Means it given as a like suppose x minus 2 ka whole square. This one is given as a q of x. Then we will also reducible or irreducible factors. So there are many cases we will study in the next passage. So I hope you enjoy the chapter and we will learn more in next chapter. So thank you. Class over.